Morning, everyone. So welcome to another presentation, and here is my colleague, an optometrist. You're welcome.
Morning, everyone.
Okay, so today she has a lot for us, and then she wants to educate us on how to take care of our eyes. So over to you, Dr. Adeze.
Thank you, Bola. Thank you for having me here.
You're welcome.
Okay, so I'll be talking about glaucoma.
All right, thank you. So please, what is glaucoma?
Okay, glaucoma is the leading cause of blindness worldwide.
Okay.
It's called the thief of the sight. It's caused by damage of the optic nerves. It's whereby the pressure in the eye, we have a fluid that is in the anterior sector of the eye. The pressure builds up because of increase in fluids in the front of the eyes. So this is what causes damage to the optic nerves. Optic nerves send information to the brain. So when the optic nerves is damaged, the vision is lost.
Yes, serious. Okay, so you mentioned that when the pressure builds up in the eye because of increased fluid, right?
Yes.
So what are the causes of glaucoma? What causes this?
Okay, actually, the cause of the glaucoma is not yet known, but there are some risk factors,
okay,
which can be some people are predisposed, age, people that are from 60 years and above are predisposed to having glaucoma. They are the risk, people that are at risk of having glaucoma. People that have family history of glaucoma. Then people that have some health conditions like diabetes and hypertension. Then people of some race like Africans, Hispanics, they are more prone to having glaucoma.
Thank you so much, Dr. Adeze. Okay, so are there types? Do we have types of glaucoma?
Yes.
Can you educate us on this?
We have types of glaucoma, but the common one is open angle glaucoma. This is one that is more common.
Okay.
It occurs when the fluid build up in the front of the eyes, and it is like a clogged pipe that it cannot drain properly, because this fluid is meant to go into the anterior parts and drain out. But when it's not possible, it's clogged, so the fluid cannot go out freely, so which causes the angle, the fluid to build, in causing increased pressure.
Okay.
Then they have the closed angle, that's the acute one, which is closed angle glaucoma, okay, which is caused by a sudden closure of this drainage angle. It suddenly closes. Those ones comes with symptoms, okay, because glaucoma normally does not show any symptom. It just happens because it's a gradual process whereby you don't know that your vision is being deteriorated. It will keep affecting your optic nerves till you lose your vision. That's why it affects mainly the peripheral vision. It starts with the peripheral vision, like you will not see things around you, but you can see things in front of you.
Okay,
so this is what happens. But for the acute, the open angle, no sign, no symptoms. That's why they call it the thief of sight. But the acute one, it happens suddenly, and you can feel a sharp pain. Okay, you feel your vision is blurred, you can't see well. Then aside from that, you also see that you feel like nauseous, like your stomach, or you have a stomach upset, then your eyes might be red. That is an emergency. If something is not done, you likely lose your sight. So you have to see an eye specialist immediately to save your sight. So they also have the congenital glaucoma, which are some children are born with glaucoma. So those ones with surgery, the child can have a better vision, okay, but without it, the child loses or her vision. They'd also have the one that is caused by medications and surgery, okay. So those ones are also another type of glaucoma.
Okay, thank you so much. You've discussed also, you've mentioned some signs and symptoms along the courses. I don't know, are there also still specific signs and symptoms aside from the ones you've mentioned?
actually, glaucoma does not have signs or symptoms in early stage. Okay. Or you know that maybe later when it advances, you notice that you can't see well again. That's why it's good to visit your ophthalmologist, optometrist, your eye specialist often to check your pressure. The eye pressure is not enough for you to know if you have glaucoma. So a comprehensive eye test is advised, whereby the doctor will dilate your eye, check your eye pressure, which is a tonometry, check your visual field. You have to check how well you see your vision well, mostly the peripheral section of the eyes. That is why the visual field test is advised. Then also the gonioscopy is done, whereby this drainage angle is checked to know if it's draining the fluid properly. This is gonioscopy. That's why you need to do the gonioscopy. Then also the doctor will do the pachymetry, where he checks the thickness of the cornea to know all those things can show that the person is a glaucoma suspect.
Okay.
Yeah, because sometimes some people have increased in eye pressure but they don't have glaucoma. Those ones is called ocular hypertension.
Okay.
So that's what differentiates it.
Okay.
So with that, with some medications, you can bring down the eye pressure, but the optic nerve is not damaged.
Okay.
Glaucoma means that your optic nerve is damaged.
Mm.
And it can lead to visual loss if not managed.
Okay.
And the damage of the optic nerve is permanent. It cannot be reversed.
Mm.
The only thing that can be done is to manage it so that further occurrence will not happen. Yeah, so that you will save your sight and you will not have visual loss. Yeah, loss
okay.
of vision.
Thank you so much. Okay, so you mentioned that sometimes there could be intraocular pressure, increased intraocular pressure, which is different from glaucoma.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So what can cause increased intraocular pressure different from glaucoma?
Okay.
What can lead to this?
Okay, like I said earlier, increase in drug, some people is sometimes is hereditary, it just happens.
Okay.
Sometimes some drugs that we take, like corticosteroids, can cause it.
Okay.
Sometimes some diseases like diabetes, hypertension can cause it too. Yeah. Sometimes lifestyle, some people that smoke, it can also make your eye pressure to go up.
Can stress cause intraocular eye pressure?
No, stress has not been linked to it,
okay.
though. Yes, stress has not been linked to it. But it's advised for us to exercise often and live a good lifestyle,
okay.
which helps to maintain a good eye health.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much. So I want to find out, during the period you were trying to mention the signs and symptoms, you also mentioned how it could be diagnosed. So I want to find out, are there treatments for this glaucoma? Do we have specific treatments for glaucoma?
Yes, we have treatment for glaucoma. We can use medications, eye drops can be used, laser therapy can be used, and also surgery. But initially, if it's not advanced, the eye drop can be used to manage. Once someone is diagnosed of glaucoma, it can be managed.
Okay.
It cannot be reversed. So the eye drops will be used to manage the glaucoma, because you have to use your eye drops daily. It's a routine eye drop that you have to use daily to control the pressure of the eye and
okay.
to control the effect on the optic nerves.
Okay.
Then the laser, they can use the laser to open the drainage angle. Yeah. Then surgeries too can be done to check,
control
the fluid, the pressure, and also control the fluid.
Okay.
So these are the treatments for.
Okay. So she already mentioned that even though glaucoma is a silent killer, it can still be managed. Meaning that once you check, it's very important for you to check your eye pressure, because it's a silent killer. Most times people don't even know they have it, but
yes.
in as much as you are able to check your eye pressure, you are able to visit the ophthalmologist or optometrist, as she has mentioned, then they can detect this early. Early detection can help to salvage the situation. It will definitely prevent the optic eye damage, because she mentioned that once the optic eye is damaged, it's irreversible.
Yes.
But for it not to be damaged, then it can be managed.
Mm-hmm.
Then the individual that has been diagnosed, we need to apply eye drops, prescribed eye drops, of course, to the eye regularly, and then you keep to your follow-up appointment. So want to find, is it hereditary? I think you mentioned during the course of
glaucoma is hereditary. It runs to family. Okay. So if you notice that your mother or your father had or have glaucoma, it's good to always check your
pointer.
Yes, to always check your eye pressure and visit your ophthalmologist, optometrist to do a comprehensive eye test to know if you're a glaucoma suspect.
Okay, thank you so much. Is glaucoma linked to cataracts? Because there are some questions that once people have glaucoma, they tend to have cataracts. Is it linked?
Actually, it's not linked, but some surgeries like cataracts, or if not done properly, it can cause glaucoma. Okay. Yeah, because cataracts is the opacity of the lens, intraocular lens. So they'll do cataract surgery to remove it. Yeah. Yes. So if it's not done properly, okay, it can lead to glaucoma, whereby the fluid in the eye cannot drain well, because it's meant to drain from the anterior to the posterior, meant to be circulating, but when it's not draining well, it clogs, it builds up and causes pressure. So this can be because when something, an injury is happens to you, or something is affecting the normal functioning of the eyes.
Thank you so much, Dr. Adeze. Do you have any advice, or is there any other word you have for the audience?
Yes, I have advice. First of all, we should maintain a healthy lifestyle. Okay. Eat food that are balanced diets. Balanced. Yes, leafy vegetables are very good. Food rich in omega-3 are very good. Food that are rich in antioxidants, carrots, tomatoes, they are very healthy. Then quit smoking. And if you have any other health conditions, try to manage it, your diabetes, your hypertension, and also you try to get a health insurance.
Yeah.
Because health insurance, we cover optical care.
Yeah.
Yes, you have a luxury of optical care where you can go to your optometrist and have your eyes checked, have your pressure checked.
Yeah.
You go to the ophthalmologist and do a comprehensive eye check. That's one of your benefits.
Yeah.
Then aside from that, if you already have glaucoma, we also manage chronic conditions. Terms and conditions applies.
Yeah.
We also manage chronic conditions whereby you get your routine eye drops. You won't say, I don't have money to buy my eye drops today. You're covered.
Yeah.
Because, and you need your eye drops monthly, every single day you're meant to use it. It's aside from that, you're going to have loss of vision. Yeah. Then you should always check
and you don't want loss of vision.
I don't want loss of vision. So you're entitled to optical care.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you don't need to have money to go for it. You just pay for your premium and you're entitled, you're covered for the whole year.
And it's just little money.
Yes.
Very little. So, and you are covered, for the entire year. Yeah, and as long as you want to be covered, you are covered.
You're covered.
In as much as you pay your dues. All right. Thank you so much, everyone. We'll see you in our next video. Bye.